All right. We're back on the ladder. We are absolutely disadvantaged by this, you know, Spedgrim's MMR, but and combat power, man. His combat power, oh, is so large. Let me go ahead and get some music playing. I've seen that it was like pretty high the last couple days, so I'm gonna lower it. I love speed, but crawlers are pretty easy to counter. Still, I like speed. Let's go speed. I like to go like speed and tanks. But right now, speed and like arc lights are actually what makes the most sense. Just like for round one. I kind of love that. Maybe this with a little added, off center. I just want to make sure that the missiles get fired at the crawlers. You know, I've had too many times where the crawlers get set too far back. And I like it when you guys are a little bit more in the pocket just for those side, you know, flanks. Let's see what happens. He also went for some arc lights. Makes a lot of sense. I like what he's doing with his fangs. It's pretty cute. I think that we have the advantage in that we have Phoenix. Phoenix is pretty hard for him to counter without these fangs getting mechanical rage. He is building like a standard defensive line, I would say. See what happens here. Do they fire their first missiles here? See, this is a little awkward. I need another squad to kind of do what this one did and draw the fire to the side. And then here, my Phoenix are kind of trying to participate in attacking things I don't really care about so much. And these ones are, again, attacking Fang. So, like, still, I think that with the fact that we have speed and range here, we're gonna be fine. Like, this is eating up a lot of time, sure, but that's not even the big thing. It's just the fact that these guys are gonna kind of come harvest. And like, these fangs, even if they turned around now, wouldn't have a chance of killing these two items, like these two units. All right, how do I take this? Instead of 8%, let's make it 5%. And then I can turn you back up. Yeah, I hate that I always seem to be playing with audio in all my videos, but it's just what's up. 50 per round is pretty sick. Heavy Mustangs. No, we'll just take a supply specialist. It's a little bit generic, but it works. So again, one unit in the center here. One more, like, bad boy over here. And we actually got enough experience for a rank up. So that's pretty, it's pretty big. Let's see where he pivots next. More fangs. More fangs makes a ton of sense. Like, he's gonna be doing some serious work with those fangs, I think. Is he just going for as many as possible? Like, I think I'm gonna end up going into like a Helion or something, but he's the giant specialist. So for now, arc lights are the call. I really want to make my arc lights have get rid of the technology disruptor and get the marksman one. So again, here we go. Missiles inbound, all in the center here. This is like the sacrificial unit. What I might do is actually try and do some of like the more advanced techniques that I've seen in the past, where people unlock pathing techniques and they just try and run their crawlers kind of like around and back. I think that could be sick. So here it looks like we're gonna lose because we just don't have the attack speed to make this work. But maybe if this one survives, then we might have enough attacks per second. No, it looks like we're double tapping one anyway. And if you hit like the, yeah, yikes, big yikes. And now you guys are attacking them when we're about to lose both of our things. That's not good. That's not good. I mean, at least both the debuffs are at the same time. So we're gonna chew through some things. But had he just killed this last Fang, he'd be at, like, basically full health. And then finish him, yeah. And we're saving a ton of HP that we would have lost otherwise, but, you know, it is what it is. Oh, I'll speed up. Yeah. Sorry. I didn't realize I had to vote on it. And he did. We got it. So, supply specialist to both of us. Extended range marksman. Assault Fang is so good for him. I don't love any of this, but I might grab this, the amplifying core, for later. Let's get the mobile beacon. Something like this. I have faith. Yeah, extended range arc lights, I think, are like the key. I could get the tech disruption on it if he does go for something interesting, but for now we're chilling. We'll get the marksman just in case. What did he grab? Assault Fangs, yeah. Increased 40% attack. They have more movement speed but less range. He then bought the range upgrade to offset them. So I think that that's a really good play on his part. Him going all in on Fangs is going to do wonders for him. And I think I didn't quite do this correctly. I went too close to the front lines before coming back. But hey, look, I mean, they are shooting all over the place. Like, there is a bunch of mess happening here. I wouldn't mind getting even more Phoenix into play here. I mean, us getting extended range, like, with a unit that's countering Fangs is great for us. What's bad is that his units are scalable. Like, he can get more Fangs quickly. They're multi-purpose. They can be very upgraded. We can go for an orbital bombardment. Let's get our units upgraded. I mean, I could give them armor, but I don't want to do that. I kind of want to hold on to this for a round. Yeah, he's got extended range now, so just to the line, I think, makes a lot of sense. I mean, for now, arc lights are king. So let's just keep buying arc lights, right? Like, it seems a little bit crazy, but it feels like it's working out. Again, I thought he was gonna buy shields or armor there, like, but no, he didn't. I grabbed the artillery. He grabbed extended range marksman. Fair enough. I mean, I need to get extended range Phoenix stuff going on here. Oh, wow. These guys can actually also move on that slant. And, yeah, missiles be firing out, but our boys are dodging. Okay, unfortunately, our range is too long because our Phoenix went in there and got hit instead of something else. But yeah, these, like, movement patterns are interesting. I'm not sure that they were great, but they certainly, like, screwed up a bunch of targeting. Look at this crawler. What a great crawler. Yeah, man. Okay. I mean, there's a lot of time left. We could take the top supply specialist here. Something like this. And then let's just bombard this flank here. And what else? I mean, I think more like Phoenix makes sense. We could start with range, but I prefer elite. But range, Phoenix, and like I'd say maybe some late crawlers, but they're not that great, so I might just do a... I kind of want to just get like a reserve like arc light, like way in the back, just in case something weird happens. Like, I don't know how much value he's really adding, but you know, so there you go. Buddy moved, he jumped back, some missiles are all over the place. The artillery actually dominated so hard. Holy damn. Did he grab top supply? Yeah, so this is gonna be like a high income round. Economy is off the charts for both of us, but he's the one that's being crushed, so. He's the giant specialist though, so I thought that he might grab giants by now. Level 3 sledgehammer tanks. I mean, that is pretty sick, actually. Holy damn, that's pretty sick. On such a high-income game, too. I think that we do that. And they can just be, like, armored bosses, right? So you unlock the sledgehammer tanks. 400 apiece. And then hand them... either mechanical range or armor. Probably mechanical range. I mean, I'm already a speed specialist, right? So 10 meters, you're 10 meters. Yeah, give me that mechanical range. And I just want them to start far enough back that the... oh, you know what? That's an amplifying core unit right there. I just want them to start far enough back that they are chilling out hard here. Okay, some smoke screen in the center. Fair enough. Some shields for him. He did go for a fortress. So he is upscaling for sure. My units are going to have to close in. Thankfully, I do have the level 3 Phoenix. So, like, that is my single target damage. These tanks are strong. Crawlers are making a mess. They're going to come in late. We do have Phoenix on this side as well. Please keep doing your thing. Looks like the shields were enough to keep his fangs kind of alive. Gotta say. Good for him. And now we're finishing off fangs while his marks would finish me off. Good for him. That was a good pivot into fortress, I think. Did he get improved fortress? Is that why he did it? I don't like redeployment. I do like a rhino, though. Not gonna lie. I want to make sure that these units do die. Like, they have to actually go in for it. Fortress is good. I mean, look. I actually think Stormcallers pop shields. They counter a ton of things. Let's buy level 2 units. And then, like... extended range and flame. Or another level 2. I think another level 2. And then, range. And then, like, let's just buy a round of range and see if that's, like, enough to, like, kind of finish this off. I'll stack up. Put a little damage missile over here, see what happens. He went all in on these fortresses, so let's see what happens. We've got range except for this bad boy. Okay, crawlers are kind of in there, running around crazy all like. Does he have the ability to build more mech dudes? No? Okay. Okay, could you guys take some good shots right now, real quick? That'd be great if you took some real shots. Okay, the fact that he lost a base to a charging rhino is pretty actually, like, sick and might end up winning us the game. Hard to say, because, like, this is, like, 300. These are, like, 200. These are 200. He got one of them. He got two of them. He just saved himself, like, 100 or 200 damage with those two kills. So, close. Production line for tanks. No, no, you just get HP of all units. I actually like the idea of just getting more tanks. I keep going back and forward on, like, Phoenix and other things, but no, no, no. You get, like, the tanks. How much? 500 for armor. That's pretty steep. But yeah, you get a couple of tanks. You get these guys kind of running in here and around. We go plus one. I want to go plus one range and plus a recruitment on another Stormcaller squad. And now we've got, like, tons. Tons of, like, anti-shield stuff going on. Okay, he's going Rocket Punch. Interesting. Maybe we just go and pivot into a Melting Point with, what would we want? A Melting Point. Well, that went way too loud. Oh, baby. A Melting Point with, like, extended range is interesting to me because it might, like, do a lot of work in terms of, like, holding back the enemy here. He still has his Rocket Punch, right? That's what this is symbolizing? Yeah, pew, pew, pew. I mean, it does a lot of frontline damage, that's for sure. And we didn't get our Rhino through this time because we don't actually have a Rhino. Losing a base is pretty painful there, too. I mean, these missiles definitely did a lot. Does he have upgraded bases? No. Non-giants, no. Lightning storm, right? Like, it's gotta be a lightning storm. We've gotta buy a whole bunch of shields for ourselves now. Then we buy a bunch of this. I talked about getting melting points, but how do you make it happen? Buy range again. Like, unlocking him, purchasing him, and giving him extended range is, like, the whole shtick. I think that we plan to go this way, but for now, we get another aerial squadron here. And then what? I already bought range. I don't like to recycle. I don't think I can shoot any. I mean, they do, like, maybe we do get just, like, one anti-missile thing and see what happens. He got the storm as well. Now, that's painful for my air units, right? Yeah. So that's a GG for him. I don't want to take so much damage that I die now, but certainly some damage has been dealt. And now I don't have any production left, unfortunately, to, like, really make this happen. He's got extended range and marksman stuff. His guys are all really low, but they're not dead. And he's getting so many rocket punches. GG, right? Just too many big boys. Man, what a great pivot. I told you he had, like, long-term wins on us. The fortress is a great pivot because it countered the tanks. And then I wasn't sure if I could put enough tanks down, but he just kept building fortress. right? Just keep building fortress. Just keep building fortress. What a, like, it's hard to lose that one. In that we were doing so well. We only lost 10 MMR because we were so underrated. But still, it was an interesting run. I'll see you next time. Ciao for now.